Shonen Jump's One Piece is truly a franchise that needs no introduction. But just in case you're unfamiliar, I'll give a brief summary. Since premiering in July 1997 in Shueisha's weekly Shonen Jump magazine, Monkey D. Luffy and his crew of lovable rogues have become household names the world over. One Piece is the best-selling manga and comic series of all time. It's been praised and awarded for its characters, its world-building, art, story, and its silly yet serious tone. All the product of the genius of one man and his team, the illustrious Ichiro Oda, often known to the fans as GOTA, referencing the acronym Greatest of All Time. Having finally gotten around to playing the new One Piece Odyssey game on my PC, this seemed like an excellent time to get my thoughts on the franchise out there and share what the series has meant to me personally, and the journey it's brought me on throughout my life. This series has meant so much to so many people, and I just wanted to share my own personal story in the hopes that anyone watching this video will do the same and share their stories in the comments below. So without further ado, I'm Elekidra, and this is Growing Up a Gamer, What One Piece Has Meant to Me. I was a nerdy kid, neurodivergent, introverted, and with a deep love of all things fiction. I played outside a lot, but never missed a cool new show or game if I could help it. So, when One Piece first came to the States in the later years of my elementary school career, you best believe my interest was piqued. I was already a big shonen fan, with years of Dragon Ball Z and Naruto under my belt. One Piece was par for the course at that point. The goofy lightheartedness was almost a breath of fresh air to an 11-year-old with few friends, and as such, a strong belief in the power of friendship. Luffy struck me as a seemingly unserious goofball, who nevertheless would put everything he had and endure torturous pains for the sake of his friends and allies. It was endearing. Would I take a vigorous stab wound, or nearly drown in the sea for the sake of my friends? 11-year-old me certainly would have liked to believe that. Of course, I didn't know that I was watching a heavily censored version that was actually significantly lighter than the subject matter. Had I known, it would have made Luffy even cooler in my opinion. I mean, using your own blood as a weapon to take down the leader of a ruthless crime syndicate? That's metal. Luffy would do anything for a friend, and that earned him the undying loyalty of those who follow him. To this day, that devotion to a friend colors the way I consider the meaning of the word friendship. Still, life is much more than the shows we watch and the games we play. The 4Kids dub of One Piece was not well received by fans, and while kids like myself who'd been unaware of the series before the dub still enjoyed it, that wasn't enough to save the localization. Episodes stopped coming, and I moved on. I had more pressing concerns in my life at the time. I started middle school, and my mom had been diagnosed with breast cancer. The cost of her treatment forced us to downsize homes, and so we moved into a different neighborhood. My new neighbors were not kind to the quiet kid who suggested that cursing was not very nice. One Piece was just another fad from my past at that point, same as Beyblade or Metabots. I was mostly unaware of Funimation picking up the rights. For the most part, I'd forgotten all about it in favor of edgier games and programs. And so, there it remained in the back of my mind, at least until 2008, and one of the worst days of my entire life. During my sophomore year of high school, in 2008, my mother passed away. My siblings and my father took it poorly. I didn't take it any better, but I had trouble crying about it. This wasn't me being tough or something like that. It just wasn't real to me yet. Summer came quickly, and that gave me time to process everything without having to worry about my schoolwork. This left me in desperate need of a distraction. I'd recently started reading manga to get ahead of my go-to shows at the time, Naruto and Bleach. But there was another member of the so-called Big Three that I'd been neglecting for years. The only one I wasn't caught up on. And one glance at the manga showed me that big things were happening in the world of One Piece. I picked up the anime where I'd left off, only this time using the sub, seeing as it was so much further ahead. The arcs of Water 7 and Ini's Lobby are well regarded in the community, and for good reason. Luffy was still giving everything for his friends, even when it seemed like his crew was falling apart around him. Turns out the newest Straw Hat pirate, Nico Robin, had a lot more going on than any of us knew. Backed into a corner and desperate to protect the only people she cared about, Robin chose to turn herself in to the world government, a sacrifice to be used for her knowledge, and then most assuredly executed. She chose to die. You can only imagine how this touched me in my grief at the time. Watching someone give up on life in order to save themselves from the pain of living on? Well, not on Luffy's watch. The power of friendship was back with a vengeance. Here were our heroes, literally ready to fight the entire world and face impossible odds for someone he considers to be like family, ready to snatch her back from the jaws of death. I know that facing down a tyrannical government isn't the same thing as combating cancer. But at the time, I could see my own drive to fight something that seems insurmountable in the characters. The drive to fight for the ones you love. A few episodes later, the crew loses their ship. And while they saved Robin, losing their ship, a friend that had been with them since the beginning of their journey, made it a nearly hollow victory. In the end, you can't save everyone. The crew had known all along that it wouldn't be long before their precious ship sailed its last. The Going Merry was terminal, much like my mother had been. This opened the floodgates for me, and I finally had that good cry that I'd been holding in for almost a month. I was finally ready to accept the reality of my situation, and it was the lessons of Ichiro Oda that had finally enabled me to do so. There's nothing quite like the catharsis of a good cry. This clinched it for me. One Piece got me through an indescribably difficult time in my life, and from that point on, it would forever be one of my favorites. But the masterful storytelling and brilliant catharsis of One Piece was only just hitting its stride. Each arc after that was as brilliant as the last, expanding the world and drawing me ever deeper into the story. The ominous portents of Thriller Bark, the gut-wrenching reality check of Sabaody Archipelago, the desperate struggle and abject failure of Impel Down and Marineford. I had a new, lifelong favorite anime. All that was missing now was a satisfactory game in the One Piece world to draw me in completely. It wasn't long after seeing gameplay footage from the One Piece Odyssey trailer before I downloaded the game. Initially, I'd dismissed the title, as, aside from Dragon Ball Z Budokai, I'd never been a big fan of anime fighting games. I had even less interest in the Dynasty Warrior-style beat-em-ups that preceded Odyssey. But a turn-based RPG-style game? That I simply had to jump on. Odyssey's combat was the thing that drew me into the game first. The turn-based combat system is reminiscent of Dragon Quest, or the turn-of-the-century Final Fantasy games. You play as the full Straw Hat crew, unlocking the abilities they possess in the show as you level and collect unlocking items throughout the world. The game employs an attack-type system that gives both the playable characters and the enemies one of three types: speed, power, or tech, in a rock-paper-scissors sort of fashion. The type of move you use will be more or less effective depending on the type of enemy being attacked. The combat did not disappoint. Now, if only I could say the same for the rest of the game. The story is sound, indicative of many non-canon One Piece films that have been released over the years. The quests, however, are a case study on everything RPG fans have come to despise over the years. Pointless fetch quests, meaningless slogs back and forth over the same terrain to reach some arbitrary destination, numerous interruptions by every conceivable NPC on your way to accomplish the one mission you actually have a reason to care about, the main one. The game almost seems to invent ways to pad out its runtime, rather than giving you actually interesting quests to optionally pursue. The game forces you to engage in nonsensical sidebars every 10 minutes. Frankly, the missions leave a lot to be desired. Am I enjoying exploring the One Piece world? Yes. Am I dragged out of that enjoyment every time the game forces me to chase some random bandit or thieving monkey that happens to cross my path? Absolutely. At the very least, they could give us a reason to care, perhaps by including some of the many side characters that we know from the anime. But no. Nameless NPC just got robbed. Better drop everything to get their stuff back. The combat is enough to keep me in the game, but I can't in good conscience call this one of the better games I've played this year. As much as I love One Piece, as much as this franchise means to me personally, I cannot in good conscience give Odyssey a stellar grade, considering the way the game is laid out. I'm not too blinded by fanaticism, to be honest here. The best I could do is a tentative pass based on the combat and story, grading each with an A- and B- respectively. The structure, however, just barely gets a C-, just inching by because the game runs without a hitch, and the quests, while uninteresting, do manage to achieve their intended purpose of padding and engaging, sort of. I love One Piece, and I find Odyssey to be an enjoyable experience, at the very least. But my dream One Piece game, one worthy of the franchise that has been so influential in my own life, has yet to be created. But hey, just like the lovable scamps of the Straw Hat Pirate Crew, I could dream, can't I? I'm Elekidra, and this has been Growing Up a Gamer, What One Piece Has Meant to Me. Please, let me know in the comments below what your One Piece journey has been. I'd love to hear about it. And also, if you wouldn't mind liking this video and or subscribing to my channel, I'd appreciate that too. I have lots more games that I want to talk about my personal journey on, and I'm curious to see what other people think of what my experience has been, and to hear about their own experiences as well. Thank you for watching.